Hey, what's going on, man? It's the MCU Watcher. We have a very special video today. Now, the big question is, director Tyler Hayward, is he a Skrull, and has the Secret Invasion already started? Now, I hope you're doing good today, and I got a crazy-ass theory for y'all. Now, your boy Tyler Hayward, man, he been acting funny. You know what I'm saying? He been acting weird. So, allow me to go in depth. If you haven't seen episode 6, you know what I'm saying? Spoilers ahead. And let me give you a slight spoiler warning, just in case my theory is right. Now, as you can see, I am on the road to 1,000 subs and on the road to 4,000 on Facebook. So, like and subscribe. You know what I'm saying? It's all about the growth. Now, in episode 6, we find out what director Tyler Hayward is after, and it's clear to see his Vision's body. Alright, now character Darcy Lewis hacks her way in the Hayward's files, and not only finding that Hayward has found a way to see inside the hex, and didn't share with everyone else, also Hayward is personally tracking Vision, as that's his main objective. He also has a hard-on for killing Wanda. Now, Wanda took Vision's body from the sword facility, and the first thing I asked myself was, what were they doing with Vision's body? And you could tell that they dismantled him. Now, of course, this dude is all around bad, but I think he may be trying to bring back Ultron, as Vision's body was supposed to be Ultron's. And the way this character acts, he acts the VA superheroes. Now, check out this scene with Tyler Hayward. Now, he's clearly getting impatient dealing with Wanda. He takes it out on Monica, Darcy, and Jimmy Woo. First insulting Monica and then kicking them out. Now, it sounds like it's real personal.
Maximoff is never going to negotiate with us. We take her out, this whole nightmare ends. We just surrender to that? Not happening.
Captain Rambo, you have become an impediment to this mission. Constantly advocating on behalf of superpowered individuals. Yes, I know your history with Carol Danvers. And all you people who left still have the luxury of optimism. You have no idea what it was like. What it took to keep the lights on. Maybe it's a good thing you weren't here when your mother died. Because clearly you don't have the stomach for this job.
Now, Darcy also finds the blood work for Monica Rambeau and tells her that Wanda's reality has rewritten her cells on a molecular level. Now, this is a photon spectrum reference, you know what I'm saying? So we've been waiting to see how Monica Rambeau would get her powers and turn her into photon. Now, I suspected that she would gain her powers from Wanda and the Hex, and then there it is. Now, back to the director. Now, the director of S.W.O.R.D. will be the perfect position to start the infiltration of Earth, as it became easy as Monica Rambeau was caught in the snap and wasn't there to take the mantle from her mother. Alright, now this entire time, you can tell Hayward is up to something. Now, in episode 5, Monica's drone idea works, but Hayward had different plans and arms the drone with a missile without letting Monica know. Now, his plan was to attack first and get rid of Wanda so he can have Vision's body. Now, if he is a Skrull, like I feel like he's trying to use Vision's tech for something big. Now, also in episode 4, he may have hinted that he also knows the ins and outs of the universe, as when Darcy was explaining her equipment, picking up CMBR, which is cosmic background radiation. Now, Director Hayward is the only one who knew what it was and explains it thoroughly. Now, the more and more time he has on screen, you see this character get more and more hostile and out of pocket. You know what I'm saying? Now, I wanted to talk more about the time period WandaVision takes place in. Now, WandaVision is 3 weeks after Endgame, and a lot of people are asking, where is Nick Fury? Now, why isn't he helping? So, the post-credits scene for Spider-Man Far From Home takes place 8 months after Endgame. So, the Russo brothers and the director of Spider-Man Far From Home explained it as General Ratales didn't start impersonating Nick Fury until after Iron Man's funeral. So, with us getting a S.W.O.R.D. Nick Fury Secret Invasion show that's going to play out in Captain Marvel 2, I think the invasion has already started in some type of way. Now, Tyler Hayward could just be a guy with an agenda and a hatred for enhanced people. Because even Jimmy Woo says right here that he's overstepping his authority.
Hayward is way overstepping his provisional authority.
He was looking for a reason to sideline us.
Now, in the way he insults Monica Rambeau, she is shocked by his unusual behavior, and they've known each other for a long time, alright? But I know this is all speculation, you know what I'm saying? But y'all leave it down in the comments what you think. Now, what type of villain is Tyler Hayward? Is he a Skrull, or is he a regular guy? Now, I just wanted to go in depth as we find out more as WandaVision goes on, you know what I'm saying? But anyone made it to the end, man, I appreciate y'all, boy.